Rays belong to a group of animals called elasmobranchs. It's the same group as sharks. This means that instead of having a skeleton the way that we do, they have cartilage-based skeletons. This means that they're really tough. Rays have very flat bodies. You'll sometimes see the bottom of the body come up against the glass and it looks like it's a mouth and a pair of eyes, but that's actually the nostrils and the eyes are on the top of the body. We have two species of ray. We have small-eyed rays and we have thornback rays. A lot of times when people see them, they think that they're stingrays, but that's a completely different species. And our two species of ray are a lot less dangerous than stingrays. Like all the other animals in the temperate tank, our rays will eat bits of fish and bits of krill and things like that. Because the mouths are on the bottom of the body, they always feed off the bottom of the tank. And so that means that we have to make sure some of the food always gets to the bottom for them to eat, because all the animals in there will eat all the food before it gets to the bottom. What we'll do is we'll put a bit of fish on the end of a bamboo stick and then we'll target feed them. So we'll put the bit of fish in front of the rays and then they'll jump on it and eat it up. Rays have a special organ which lets them detect electrical signals. This is almost like a sense that we don't have, so it's a bit hard to imagine it. So they'll be able to use this to tell that there's other animals around them, and so they can use this to avoid predators but also hunt prey as well. Our rays will spend a lot of time resting on the bottom of the tanks, and they'll only really swim around if they're like looking for food or just having a little explore.